Hey guys, this is Leia from leiaforsci.com, and in this video, we're going to talk about a timing strategy, or should I say a pacing strategy, for the science and cars sections on the MCAT. This is a strategy that I've been working on with my students, getting them to a point where they can confidently go into the exam knowing, no matter what, they're going to finish on time. As with any strategy, keep in mind, just because it works for someone else doesn't mean it's going to work for you. So learn the strategy, try it out, practice it, and then evaluate. Does it work for me as is? Do I want to tweak it a little bit and then use something similar or just try something completely different? And one more thing, to make this strategy work, you have to already be at a point where you can finish your passages in a reasonable amount of time. That's about 10 minutes for a CARS passage and 8 minutes for the sciences. If you need help getting to that point, this will be part of an upcoming series on my website, leiaforsci.com/timing. So why this strategy? A lot of students go into the exam, they work through the section as quickly and efficiently as possible, and then when they finally look at the timer, there's 5 minutes and 3 passages left. Not enough time to finish, so they wind up guessing and then missing out on at least a dozen questions. Or, and this is less common, some students will be so anxious to get through it that they'll finish the entire section, realize they rushed and have 20 or 30 minutes to go, and because they were rushing, they may have missed some questions where a little bit of extra time would have helped them think through it better. Now, there are many strategies out there. Some work for some people, some work for others. But the strategy where you have, if I have 5 questions, I'll take this many minutes. If I have 6 questions, I'll take that many minutes. And if I have 8 questions, I'll take 2^3 × 7 minutes. It's too much thinking. You already have enough pressure and enough math to do in the MCAT that you don't want to be adding something like this. And so the strategy I've developed is very simple. This is how much time I have per passage. This is how many passages remaining. This is what the clock should read. Don't look at the clock the entire section because that's too much pressure, but don't ignore it. Just glance up at the clock quickly and know this is where I am and this is where I should be. If I'm not where I should be, if I'm too fast or too slow, I simply fix it, move on to the next passage, check the time again, move on to the next passage, check the time again. So you never get to a point at the last minute where you have 5 minutes and 3 passages because that just doesn't work. As a quick reminder, the CARS section has a total of 9 passages that you have to complete in 90 minutes. Math is very easy. 9 passages, 90 minutes. That gives you 10 minutes per passage. The first column on your scrap is simply by the end of passage number blank. But you're not going to write that down. That takes too much time. The red is just me reminding you what it is. And what you're going to write down is simply by number. The second column is going to be your time remaining, and all you're going to write down is time. Okay. So what does the math have to look like? Very simple. By the end of passage 1, the clock should read 80. By the end of passage 2, 70, and so on. It's very easy to do the math here because if you have 10 minutes of passage, you just go 80, 70, 60, 50, and so on. Don't worry about copying this down because I have an image for you on my website at leiaforsci.com/timing.
Science is a little different because in addition to the passages, you also have 15 discrete questions that are just sprinkled throughout the section. For this, I recommend starting with the discretes. Let's face it, you sit down to a section, you're very nervous, you start reading the first paragraph, it's not going in because you're still trying to calm down. But if you go to the discrete, it's a short question. You either know it or you don't. And if you don't know it, you quickly know to move on. But if you do know it, now you feel confident. 30 seconds in, I already answered a science question. 60 seconds in, I already answered more than a science question. So you work through the discretes, and then you start your timing strategy for the science passages.
The science section is a little trickier. First, you have 15 discretes. Then you have 10 passages to complete in a total of 95 minutes. If you start with the discretes in a total of 15 minutes, that leaves you with 80 minutes to complete 10 passages, which leaves you just 8 minutes per passage. 8 minutes is a little harder to calculate unless you look at this trick. For the two columns, we have, by the end of this number, by the end of passage X, the time should say what? The clock should say what? We'll use D for the discretes. The clock should say 80, taking 15 minutes off the top. And then we want to subtract by 8 for each passage. If you're looking at this and going, uh-oh, Leia, I thought you said there was no more difficult math. There's actually a fun trick where if you recognize it, this becomes very easy. If we have 8 minutes of passage, 8 is just 2 shy of 10. That means if we take 8 off any number, we drop the number by 10 and bring it up 2. First, look at the pattern. If we have 80, we go down to 70 and add 2, 72. Go down to 62, add 2. Go down to 54, add 2. Once you get that, let's make it even simpler. You ready? Write out your column starting with the tens place. Just write this out. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Repeat the 4, that's the only thing to memorize. 3, 2, 1, and these are both zeros. Once you have that, we're going to add 2. Because remember, we went down by 10, and now we're adding 2. You're going to write out the second column, 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, which is 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, which is 0. And that's it. There you have your timing.
So how does this look on actual test day? Do not start your section and then start doing the math, because you're wasting time and you're already burning into that first passage. Instead, use the few minutes leading up to the exam section to write down your times. This should take you less than 30 seconds. So if you do this with a minute to go, use the remaining time to calm down, to breathe, to meditate, and then you're ready to go. The entire exam, you quickly look at the clock, look at your scraps, and keep going. But this means you have to have the numbers memorized rather than doing the math on test day. So use the active writing strategy linked below to commit these numbers to memory so that you're not trying to calculate it on test day. This strategy is very similar to what I use for running, because I go into the race knowing my expected pace. If I go too fast, I burn out and then I have to slow down too much. If I go too slow, I'm playing catch up. But if I check my watch at strategic intervals, then it's very easy to speed up just a little or slow down just a little, and then I sprint at the finish line. But that's for running, not for the MCAT. So you write out your pacing strategy, you start the exam, and then after the first passage, you realize, crap, I'm already off track. What do I do? Well, there's two ways you're off track. You're either too fast or you're too slow. Well, if you're too slow, guess what? Congratulations! Congratulations on figuring out right away that if you continue at this pace, you're going to run out of time. It's so much easier to course correct when you're just 4 minutes off after passage one than 5 minutes remaining and 3 passages to go. In fact, if you're 4 minutes too slow on a science passage, you have time for just 7 passages and you're going to run out of the last 3. So let's fix it right away. You finish the passage and you realize you're too slow. Correct your timing right then and there. Go into the next passage knowing I have to do this one a little bit faster. If that means reading a little bit faster, working through the questions faster, abandoning questions that you know you're not going to get right faster, whatever you have to do to cut a minute or two off this next passage to save you time at the end. And yes, going faster means you might miss a question or two, but would you rather miss a question that you can't really figure out anyway? I mean, some of them are just so hard. Would you rather miss the difficult question now or not have time for 3 at the end that you may potentially get right if you had the time to go through them? Don't necessarily correct it all at once, meaning don't cut 4 minutes off passage 2, but if you can go a little faster on passage 2, buy back a minute or two. Another minute or so faster on passage 3, buy back that second or third minute, but be very conscious of the fact that you have to keep speeding up. You're going to get yourself on track and finish the section very close to on time. If you have to rush a little, again, you're not aiming for a 132. You're not, right? You're not aiming for a 132. You're just aiming for a score that's competitive enough to get you into medical school. That's it. Your MCAT score doesn't even matter so long as you get into medical school. And what happens if you're too fast? Do you just go back at the end of the section and see everything that you missed? I'm going to caution you against it. I know it sounds counterintuitive, but I want you to think about the mentality of this exam. You have 15 discretes and 10 science passages for ChemPhys. Then you have 9 cards passages. Then you have another 15 questions and 10 passages for bio-biochem. And the same thing again for psych-soch. That means your brain is going into a passage, out of a passage, into a passage, out of a passage. You don't want to be committing any of this to memory because you need a clean slate going into the next passage. And if you finish the section, you ideally forgot everything that you just read because that was a lot. Now you go back, you have a short question, but you have to remember that entire passage. And if you don't remember the passage, now you have to reread an entire passage. That's costing you way too much time. Instead, if you finish the passage and you realize you're a minute too fast, you know what? A minute's fine. If you're 2 minutes or more ahead of the target, do not continue to the next passage. Instead, redo that passage right there. That could mean skimming the entire passage again. Maybe you missed something the first time and skimming it again will help you catch it. Or reread the questions, reread the answer choices. If something wasn't clear, take the time now, while the information is still fresh on your mind, to see if you can fix something or become more confident about a question. And if you really, really have nothing left to do in this passage, close your eyes, meditate for 30 seconds, then go into the next passage thinking, I'm going to be a little slower, a little more careful in how I read the passage, the questions and the answers, and hopefully that extra focus will give you another question here and there, and ultimately a higher score. One area that you might want to finish early is psych-soch, but only if you know you honestly gave it all the time it needed. The real exam alternates between a very long psych-soch and a short, fast one, so some exam students run out of time. Multiple students on the same day run out of time, and some exams are just everybody finishes fast. But don't finish fast because you're burnt out and you just want out of the exam because you don't want to miss a few points when you're so close to the end. Finally, if the reason you struggle with pacing is because you just take too long per passage, then it's strategy that you have to work on, not just your timing. And this varies for every student, because you first have to figure out what specifically is slowing you down. I'll be tackling different techniques for improving your passages in an upcoming series on my website, leahforsci.com/timing. But first, give this video a thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out on upcoming videos. Then let me know in the comments what you think. Can you see yourself implementing this right away? And if you've tried it, did it work for you? Did it not work for you? I'd love to hear how it turned out.